Hi guys, this is the Limited Pool, a channel for development enthusiasts covering topics in Scala and functional programming. We continue the lessons in Scala today, reviewing a very famous sequence known as the Fibonacci sequence and how to implement it on Scala. Enjoy!
Well, let's start talking about the history of the Fibonacci. The Fibonacci sequence appears in Indian mathematics in connection with Sanskrit prose. Susanta writes that the development of the Fibonacci sequence is attributed in part to Pingala 200 years before Christ, later being associated with Virahanka at the year 700. Okay, it was first described in Indian mathematics, and in the West, first appearance was in 1202 by Leonardo of Pisa, most known as the famous Fibonacci. The Fibonacci sequence was first used in the 20th and 19th century number theorist Edward Lucas. Background. Fibonacci numbers are the numbers in the form of the sequence 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and are defined by the relation of a function of n is the sum of fn minus 1 plus fn minus 2. By definition, the first two numbers in the Fibonacci sequence are 1 and 1, or 0 and 1, depending on the chosen start point of the sequence, and each subsequent number is the sum of the previous two. More info about the Fibonacci number, you can do some research at wikipedia.org. Alright, fellows, let's start the implementation of code, creating a new Scala worksheet for implementation of Fibonacci sequence. Let's name it Fibonacci. Right. First of all, we must define a function and name it Fibonacci. It receives an int parameter and returns a list of int. Why? This returns all those whole numbers from the Fibonacci sequence. It must return something like that. Okay, let's start the implementation. We'll define a new list buffer. Of type int. This declaration of the list buffer. For example, the list buffer allows us insert more positions, and it's not fixed range, a simple list or array, because those tools aren't mutable. In a Scala, list and array are considered immutable. That's why we are using the list buffer and must import in our program. Scala dot collection mutable list buffer, because our list is first time is empty, but we need put more positions here. That's why we created a list buffer. Right, next we define a for In Scala, the fork can have many forms, but the most common is using an index int starting with a fixed value until a final value. So it will start in 0 and repeat until equals then L parameter, the L input. EI index starts from 0 to L. This is our for. Inside the for, we do a test, a logic. If I greater than 1, because in Fibonacci classic sequence we maintain 1 until the third position. Remember, it starts with 1, 1, and after 2. The third position is 2, so we must maintain the first one here. So that's why we added the sentence here. If I greater than 1, it would lead to an invalid result because I would increment itself too early. If not put this sentence here, it would increment I for to 0, for 1, 2, and will lead to a wrong result. Okay, after we accumulate list is list I minus 1 plus list I minus 2. If I greater than 1, so it starts the Fibonacci sequence itself. If index is greater than 1, we add to list buffer sum of list I minus 1 plus list I minus 2. It's based on the mathematical definition we've seen before in the form of Fn. Fn equals then f of n minus 1 plus fn minus 2. It's the mathematical form of the Fibonacci sequence. Right. So if index of 4 is equals then 1, I will just add to list buffer the number 1. Else list plus equals 1. It will accumulate the 1 2 times here. We can use the signal plus and equals for adding values in a list buffer. It's the same thing in Java when you call the add function on a collection is the same thing of this signal here of the accumulator. And the first function will repeat until equals then L. So it will return a list with L positions passed. It's our input parameter here. The final line, we must convert the list buffer to a list using the toList function. It will return a list, a fixed ranged list. Right. Okay. And give us a list with ints and the Fibonacci sequence values. Let's test our function using Fibonacci of 11 and printing. Okay, we had some the Scala worksheet evaluated at the left here all the values, but if you want to print the result, we can use the function for each and pass in the println here inside the function for each. It's the same of doing that x declaring an anonymous function using the println x and println. Okay, this is the imperative form of using the of coding the Fibonacci function. Let's try implementing it without using a form in a more functional way. In a non-imperative way, we don't have the for instruction. So our new function Fibonacci won't have the for. It will be purely recursive. We will still need the L input parameter because we need to know how much values I need inside the final list of Fibonacci, because the Fibonacci sequence is infinite. But we can run forever our programs, so we'll pass a value here. The second parameter will be a counter. A counter for what? We will see. And the list, the final list with the results could be the same list buffer, no problem. We pass it as an accumulator here. All the results will be inside this list of input. The return is unit. It's equivalent to do for doing a void in Java. Unit. It doesn't need to return anything because we are using this list to get in the result, the final result. The same we need a sentence at the first that checks if the counter is less than one, because the counter less than L, sorry, because the counter can't reach the L items. It's the maximum values inside the list, so the counter will be increment until the L. If we pass 3, the counter can't be greater than 3. Inside this block of if, we implement the logic of the Fibonacci. If C less than 2, list add 1. For the same problem we see in the past of the functional privileges defined for doing the first two, the first ones. It's the same needed. The counter can be greater than n for doing the for putting the first ones. Else we accumulate, we add values on the list. List counter minus 1 plus list counter minus 2. It's the same thing of the previous function, ftn minus 1 minus 2. It's the same function. For the formal mathematical definition of the Fibonacci function. After that, after doing this adding the result, we call Fibonacci 2 recursively, passing the L, the counter plus 1, we increment the counter, and the same list. plus it again. Let's test Fibonacci 2, 11. A counter must be start with 0 and a new. No, let's create a list buffer first. List buffer of type int and pass it. Pass the list and get list. Let's print it and see what's inside. Well, in fact, we did a little mistake here. And if C is not only less than L, can be equals. So if you just put less than, it won't recursive until the last position. That's why our function don't have the 144 here. It will be the last. If you put here equals, it will works as expected, equals then the first version.
Okay guys, this is all about the Fibonacci functions. I hope you will enjoy. Please send me a mail to lambdapool@gmail.com. Thank you for watching and see you around.